you know, there's going to be a lot of people who post a video of them, I don't know, singing different things. There's people that, you know, are doing like porch concerts and go out on their porch and start singing. There's people who play instruments who will go out on their porch or their street and start playing for the neighborhood. I think we're going to see a lot more of that as people really start to soak into this quarantine. Any sort of skill or something that you can provide for your neighborhood, Bob? Have you thought about this, or
I can play my nipples
dances in the week you've been quarantined? You can do.
I can play my nipples. I can play my nipples like bongos.
Okay, so as a service to get everybody's mind off whatever they're going through in a coronavirus pandemic, can you give us a little treat here? Is this a service you're going to provide for your neighborhood, or is this something you're just going to do for our listeners as a little treat? I mean, here, showing off your talents.
If one of my neighbors has like a didgeridoo or some other type of instrument, I'm willing to play with them.
If I had a didgeridoo, I'd walk my ass to your house in a T-Rex costume right now. Oh my gosh, we'd be unstoppable.
You hear that? Yeah.
I do. Yeah. Wow.
Yeah. Yep. That was Sticks Renegade. Get fired up.
I did not.
Fired up.
Come on, Pittsburgh. We all need to take care of each other and get through this together. That was Sticks Renegade.
Here, Bob.
Here we go. Let's get fired up to beat this Rona.
You hear Bob playing on his nipples? Let's get fired up, Pittsburgh. Let's go.
Hey, by the way, is your daughter and your son awake for school yet, Bob, at your house?
I hear people upstairs. I'm in the basement, though, so I don't know. I don't go upstairs.
Okay. Well, the reason I asked was I was thinking if your, you know, daughter or son just woke up from school and wanted to come down and say good morning to you, and you're just in your basement shirtless playing your nipples as bongos, and the first thing they hear dad say for the day is that was Sticks Renegade. Your house has to be pretty interesting.
Kids. Fired up. First day back at school, get fired up.
Hey, you need to go upstairs and walk up in your kitchen right now, and maybe your kids are eating breakfast and just start smacking your nipple bongos. Oh, man. Just go upstairs and just start smacking your nipples and just go, that was for Kenny. That was the gambler. R.I.P. to the gambler. That's for you, Kenny Rogers. A little tribute. Give your kids a little tribute on their first day of school. Oh, gosh. I feel like we can somewhat keep the show serious and still sort of on message. Global pandemic. Hey, our lives are changing, and we salute all the people out there working, and especially, you know, in the healthcare field and doctors and nurses and all that stuff. And then once me and you are like a couple hours into the show, you're shirtless in your basement playing nipple bongos for our listening audience.
Just like a
You're
porch
providing
concert,
the
man.
Medicine that some of us need.
Just getting everybody fired up for the day.
I feel like we need to figure out a day and a time and do Bob's basement concerts where you play nipple bongos and people like on Instagram Live or something like that can send in different requests, and maybe like once a week for 20 minutes you put on a nipple bongo show in your basement. No, maybe no.
I don't want to lock my nipples into a full performance.
Oh, you don't want to commit to a date and time for a nipple show?
Mm-mm.
Oh, that's true. Let us try to get into somewhat of a normal schedule as our kids start their online schooling today. And yeah, and then maybe at some point we can have a... You don't want listeners to send different requests and everything for your nipple bongo?
I don't want the nipples to get too tender either. You can't overuse the instrument.
That's why I said maybe once a week.
Like it can only sing a sweet song for a little bit.
You're right. Beating on your nipples for 20 minutes, even once a week, might be
irreversible damage.
What is our show?
I just said. My nipples go from Audis to Innies. Anytime Six Renegade comes on.
Anytime Styx Renegade comes on, your nipples pop back out, but it's only the Styx Renegade. Can nipples be innies? I don't think that's a real thing. I don't think nipples are outies or innies like belly buttons are.
If I smack them enough, they will be.
You have to, hold on, like when runners run up marathons, sometimes they'll put like band-aids, you know, like on their nipples so their nipples don't bleed. That's how you're gonna have to be whenever you go to a Steeler game. You're gonna have to like put band-aids on your nipples. Steelers need a big stop in the fourth quarter on defense. Oh gosh. Bob's nipples are gonna peek out here. Oh gosh, you're like, oh no, they're going from innies to outies. Bob, are you okay? You're just everybody else is cheering, you're just in your seat yelling in pain, like, ah, they're going hot, they're going hot. My daughter is like 10 feet away from me trying to do her schoolwork, and I'm yelling about your nipples.
Yeah, welcome back to school.
Amanda sent us a message here. Just want to say thank you to the other men and women in the military and their contractors who are away from their families at this time. It's hard being on base knowing that people are due to come home who've been away from their families for months already. We aren't allowed to travel due to being in countries with closed borders. Not knowing when we can actually come home is difficult. Yeah, obviously, man. Salute to all the people that work in the militaries and different military contractors that are away from their family and country travel. There are so many different restrictions on that to where somebody, you might have been planning for them for months or years to come home, and now their date is all, you know, sort of screwed up and everything. Bob, why don't you play God Bless America for all the people out
there? I don't know if I'm trained in that one. Let me try to freestyle it.
Okay. Here. Okay, go. Oh, man.
Oh, wow. Oh, man. Oh, that kind of hurt. That was it, though. Thank you.
Oh, what a salute. I actually stood up in my room and I was saluting. I don't know why. Nobody can see me. There's no sort of video on this at all, but I just stood up and started saluting. Yes, obviously our show is going to be a weird mix of serious and not serious. It was kind of a little bit of both there. But yes, obviously everybody that's in our services and connected to the military and might be overseas, yes, thank you for your service. We obviously appreciate it now more than ever during this pandemic. Mikey and Bob, more from our home shows next. Oh, God bless you, Bob.